c'è la luna menzumara, mamma mia, mamma di dare. Figlia mia, cosa dare, mamma mia, pensaccia tu. Se te piglia lo pesce, io le isso vai, isso vene, se lo pesce, manatena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia dei pescioli a vecchiuzza mia, la la riola, pesce fritto e baccalà, uè gomba, no calamara c'ha giaccata. Second stanza. C'è una luna mezzumara, mamma mia, mamma ridare. Figlia mia, cosa dare, mamma mia, pensaccia tu. Se te piglia lo polizia, isso vai, isso vena, sembra scuppetta manatena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia di scuppettia, figliuzza mia, la la riola, pesce fritto e baccalà, uè gomba, una scuppetta c'ha giaccata. And now for you nice ladies and gentlemen out there who don't understand the Italian language, I'd like to do two choruses in British. Lazy Mary, you better get up, she answered back, I am not evil. Lazy Mary, you better get up, we need the sheets for the table. Lazy Mary, you smoke in bed, there's only one man you should marry. My advice to you would be, is to pay attention to me. You'd better marry a fireman, he'll come and go, go and come, zembala bomba manatena.
Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace. How are we today, Mrs. Perini?
Oh, fine. Lovely Mass today, Father Joe. You wanted to see me?
Yes. As you know, this is when we nominate a woman for the St. Thomas Catholic Woman of the Year Award. Well, this year, I'd like to nominate you.
Holy. Oh, Father, thank you.
Don't go thanking me just yet. Sister Marianne has nominated Joyce Glad.
Joyce Glad?
Just because she's president of the PTA and she did help solve that murder last year, she's already got a leg up.
Tell me, Father Joe, what do I have to do?
Father Finocchio is with me on this, but Sister Carol is with Sister Marianne, so it's two against two. Now, Sister Carol has suggested that we bring in a third party to make the decision, so I suggested Father Brian from St. Francis.
Oh, yes. He's head of Catholic American Families Together Program, right, the CAFDP.
See, and that's where you're strong. You have got the perfect family. Your husband, a retired fire captain. Your son, a hero police officer. We'll show those nuns a thing or two.
Yes, Father. And Joyce Glad. We'll show her, too. No good Irish son.
I'm sorry, what? What was that?
Nothing. Continue.
And your daughter Carmela. She works for the mayor's office. You've practically won already.
Yes. Yes.
How is Carmela? Is she engaged or married at this point?
No, not yet. But she is dating someone, and I'm sure she's thinking about marriage.
Carmela, that one's gorgeous.
Amy, I would look stupid in that.
Yeah, you're right.
Hey!
I'm joking. You look fabulous.
Mrs. Perini. And how are you today?
Please, Jim, call me Rose.
Okay, Rose. And how is your day going?
Great, Jim. Thank you for asking. And I have to say, your flowers look just great, Chip.
Well, thank you.
How do you have the best garden on the block? I mean, it's even better than mine. What's your secret?
Love, Rose. I give them lots and lots of love.
Well, I can't see how you could ever lose the Neighborhood Garden of the Year award.
I certainly hope I do win. I could really use that rhododendron bush they're giving away as a prize. It would be a lovely addition to my garden.
Well, I guess I'm going to have to run your garden over with my car so I could win.
Rose!
Enjoy the rest of your day, Jim. Good luck.
Thank you.
What is the matter with her?
Anthony Jr. left her again.
How long has she been here?
You make a better door than a window. Move!
How long?
About an hour ago.
And you're in here watching a game?
It's Sports Center.
Susan, please stop crying. Okay, he's gonna be back. You know he always comes back.
No, not this time. He's gone to his girlfriend's.
Girlfriend? He's such a jerk to fall for his bullshit. I should go over there. You know who she is? And where she lives?
Her name is Rita Burns. She lives in Carroll Gardens, 16 Court Street, between Union and President. Top bell.
Oh, you have done your research.
She's only 20 years old!
I think that's Christine and Roger's daughter.
Okay, look, here's what I want you to do. You go home now.
Home?
Home. Up we go. Going home. Here we go. You have a couple of espressos. Two or three, perhaps. And you relax. It's going to be perfectly fine. I'm going to take care of it.
Mom.
Don't you worry about it at all. It's Rose, honey, Rose. You go home. Don't worry. Don't think about it at all because I'm going to take care of it. It's going to be great. You go home. It's going to be fine. Bye-bye.
I can't believe you stopped her from going over there.
Well, that's because I'm going over there.
You can't be serious.
I'm serious, all right.
Is that a good idea?
Yes. No, I'm not sure. All right, don't worry about it, okay? Just do me a favor. Anthony! Call your daughter Carmela. Have her come over for dinner tonight. Dove sono le chiavi? See, Anthony, help me find my keys. I want to see her today.
She'll probably bring Amy.
That's fine. Just get her over here.
Can I help you, ladies?
Hi. Actually, we're just looking at wedding dresses.
Which one of you is the bride?
Actually, we both are.
How romantic. A double wedding. Jessica, I'm gonna need some help here. We have several of the best dresses on the market. Bill Lefkoff, Jacqueline, Private Collection. Last year I did a double wedding on the Upper West Side. I gave them a great deal on two gowns from the Diva Sposin collection. They looked beautiful. Jessica, hurry up, please. Now, if you want, I could call Emmanuel Couture and see if I could get my hands on a 2008 dress before they hit the market. Your husbands will love you in them.
Actually, it's one wedding, two brides.
You can't be serious.
I'm serious. Do I look serious?
Look serious? And do I look serious?
Hon, you definitely look serious.
Ladies, so you mean to tell me that you two are actually...
It's okay, you can say it. Lesbians or lovers.
Hi, Dad.
It's okay, we're still gonna buy a dress.
So help me God.
Anthony, I think it's your mother. Anthony, it's your mom. Oh.
Open this door.
Maybe we'll all go to breakfast together.
No, she's not.
All right, well, then we'll have Cocoa Puffs.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? What are you doing here? Listen here, you little homewrecker.
Ma, please, okay?
I'm not a homewrecker. Anthony and I are in love.
Yes, we are, okay?
Anthony.
Yes.
Rita, I know your parents. They would not approve of you dating my loser son.
He's not a loser.
Thank you.
I wouldn't marry a loser.
Marry? Do you know that my son is already married?
Yeah, but he's getting a divorce, right, Anthony?
Yes, I'm getting a divorce.
No, we are not animals.
Are we getting a pet? Let's get a dolphin.
We don't get divorced.
Well, I am, okay, so...
Yeah, and then we're gonna go to Vegas where we get married by Elvis.
Okay, reason, honey. You have to relax with that baby.
But that's what you told me last night.
I know.
Anthony, you promised. No,
relax.
You promised I want to get married by Elvis.
I know. We'll talk about this.
Vegas, my ass! You look at me when I talk to you, Anthony Jr. You get home and you fix your family.
What family? I'm not going back with her, okay? Okay, Rita, you have to relax with that baby shit.
You promised. You said we could get married by Elvis.
Putana.
Ma,
what'd
please.
What'd she say?
How could you leave her again?
What are you talking about, Ma? I'm not happy. Could you just go, please?
Happy? You're married. Who said anything to you about being happy? Do your father and I look happy?
You know, this is the 21st century. People get divorced if they're unhappy.
And in love.
Oh, you're leaving a wonderful girl for a fling?
A wonderful girl? You don't even like Susan. What are you talking about?
That's not the point!
I know this is a lot to take in right now, Mrs. Preeny, but I just know that me and you, we're gonna be like best friends.
Don't read it. No. That ain't gonna work.
Do you have herpes?
What? Ma, look, can you just go, please?
Look, you didn't tell Father Joe about this, did you?
Okay. Why the hell would I tell him?
What I mean is, if you want marriage counseling, Father Joe isn't very good at that. You need to go to another priest, like in a different parish, like Jersey or something.
What the fuck are you talking about? Mom, my marriage is over. okay?
Dio mio, I had such hopes for you. Fai schifo.
She talks funny.
Here, right? You have to do this here? I mean, 6 months ago, I was the hero cop's son. You told all the neighbors, you called Aunt Franny, Aunt Barbara. Now, all of a sudden, I'm the worthless, degenerate loser son?
I never said worthless. Oh my God, Anthony, I have this great idea. After you kick out your ex and sell your house, you should use all that extra money to fly your whole family to Vegas for our wedding. Maybe I should start calling you Mom.
Rita, please, just drop it, please.
You are not the son I hoped for.
Well, you're not the mother I hoped for either, okay? So that makes us even.
Well, thank God I have Carmela.
Who's Carmela?
Carmela's my not-so-perfect sister.
Hey, don't you dare say anything bad about your sister. She has never done anything to make me ashamed of her, and she never would. I'll see you at Sunday dinner.
Bye, Mom.
She's not invited.
I swear, Bill.
Isn't it great about the award?
I'm very happy for you.
Thank you. I do need to write a personal statement, though, and I was hoping you could give me a hand with it.
Sure. Tell me what you want to say. I'll draft something for you.
That would be great. And write something for yourself, too, for when you meet them.
What? Why do they want to meet me?
I think they want to make sure that, you know, everyone is okay.
What does that mean?
Well, that everything is normal.
Ma, what are you talking about?
Well, like the fact that you're not married and you're 35.
So,
I think it would be a good idea if you told the committee you're dating a nice Catholic man.
You want me to lie?
It won't hurt anybody.
It will hurt me. You're ashamed of me because I'm not married.
No, not ashamed. Disappointed. A little. I mean, most women are married by the time they're 35.
Well, Ma, guess what?
I am getting married.
You don't have to lie that much. Just say you're dating someone who's Catholic and Italian.
Should I say he's an astronaut who's bionic, too?
Well, let's not go crazy. Just say he's a doctor.
Ma, listen. I'm not lying. I'm getting married to Amy.
Oh, boy.
I'm sorry I'm telling everyone like this, but me and Amy plan on getting married next month, and we're going to try and have a baby.
What are you talking about?
You know damn well what I'm talking about. Ma, I'm 35. I live with a woman. I never date men.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
Let me spell it out for you, Ma. I'm a lesbian. L-E-S-B-A-N.
Actually, hon, you spelled that wrong. It's L-E-S.
Can you shut up, please?
If you're an L-E-S-B-I-A-N, you can't have a baby.
Wrong again.
Okay, so who's the lucky guy?
Haven't you heard anything I just said?
No, and I don't want to hear it.
Let me say this slowly. Amy and I are going to get married next month. Again, I am sorry I'm informing everyone like this, but we couldn't wait anymore. We intend to go to a sperm bank, and then we wait 9 months, and then we have a baby. Me, Amy, and the baby, we want us to be one big, happy family, including Anthony Jr., or whatever it is we call happy.
God in the heavens, pray for us.
Mr. and Mrs. Perini, I'm sorry we didn't tell you earlier, but me and Carmela, we care about each other very much.
This is worse than I thought.
Did you speak to Father Joe about this?
Yeah, Ma. I went down to the church and told Father Joe I'm a lesbian and I'm getting married before I told my parents. Amy, you tell the mailman?
Hey, don't be a smartass, okay?
You want to be part of my life, you have to accept us.
I don't have to do any such thing.
Fine. We're out of here.
Fine!
We're out of here.
Sorry.
Fine.
If you're leaving, take some leftovers home with you.
Fine, I will.
Listen. Carmela. Congratulations. See you at Sunday dinner.
Thanks, Daddy.
Dinner was wonderful, Mr. Perini.
You're welcome. Why are you judging her? That's not our job. Our job is to accept her no matter what.
Please, don't give me that AA crap.
Rose, come on. Our first grandchild. You heard your mother didn't win.
Yeah, we heard.
Bate, schifo!
And as you can see, your mother's a little upset. And you, you jackass, you couldn't wait for the divorce to come through? Look, shut up, Gil. Don't even finish.
Look what they did.
What are you laughing at? Why'd you have to wait so long to tell us about the wedding, Carmela?
Daddy, I'm sorry. I'm
look,
sorry.
I don't want to hear it. Hello, Amy.
Hi, Mr. Perini.
You know, you could have said something too, huh?
Sorry, Mr. Perini.
Maybe you should start calling me Dad. Huh?
Damn it.
Entriamo! Dinner's ready! Let's
damn.
Go!
God damn shit!
Essi vuoi venire, da porta bruccolina, ti faccio vedere i corne musoline. E gira, gira, gira la là. Mannaggia mustazze parte, le femmine sono fatte per mangiare e l'uomo sono fatte per gettare lo sangue a faticare. Second paragraph. L'ha portata lo muovo in piccio per se fare divertire, ma chiamata sana mangogna e mi ha fatto scomparire. E gira, gira, gira l'ariola. Mannaggia mustazze parte, le femmine sono fatte per mangiare e l'uomo sono fatte per gettare lo sangue a faticare. Translation, I think. I love you, my skinny Lena, but people stop and stare. You look just like a broomstick with a great big mop of hair. When I take you to a party, you should look just like a dream. But oh, my little kookootsa, you look like Halloween. Oh, why do people stop and stare?
So this is nice, right? Oh, isn't that nice? Isn't that nice?
As you know, this is when we nominate a woman for the St. Thomas Catholic Woman of the Year Award. And this year, I'd like to nominate you.
I'm trying to compliment you. It's good, but it's a
she
little thick.
Yeah, it's a little dry. Yeah. So what are you two going to name the alien child?
Amy, your sweetheart.
Amy is a sweetheart. You can all leave and leave me here. I'll have a meal with Amy and you can all go.
What I say, my thing, it's great.
Don't talk with your mouth full. What the hell's the matter with you?
Who do you think I learned it from?
Never mind.
We have several of the best dresses on the market. Bill Lefkoff. Vera Wang. Sorry. I'm sorry.
Trying to arrest some guy and she's breaking my balls.
Tay, explain to him what it is to be a man and a husband. You take care of your household and your wife and your marriage and you work on stuff.
Look, we had two kids. This is the way I look at it. We had two kids. One is a freaking idiot. Okay, so we're batting 500, honey. Don't worry about it.
I'm joking. You look fabulous.
Pause. I got the level.
Shut up, Andy.
Today.
Let your sister talk.
What's for desserts? But
let your sister talk.
I think we're going to get married outdoors instead of in a
That's it?
Church.
The fuck is that?
Hey.
Shut up.
Watch your mouth.
God, I hate you.
As soon as Joyce stops choking, I could heal her.
45-minute mass.
No,
I got
mass.
No problem.
No
mass,
you're
going to
get
married. You hate it. I
said I got no problem.
You can't wait to sit down at the reception and eat, please.
I had to have a mass in my wedding. Now she's going to get away without having
it. Well, that worked out just beautifully,
there you
didn't
go.
It?
Mother, anyway. Mother wants to know who's going to officiate the wedding. That's what she's asking.
I'm asking.
It's not going to be a priest.
She's married a girl. It's a special wedding. She don't have to have a mass. I don't understand.
Two brides. You can't be serious.
Definitely lock this in.
So you're going to have a wedding, you're going to have an official, right, outside.
It'll be outside, it'll be beautiful.
And you're going to pay for it? Who's going to pay for
this? No brains.
I can't believe you just asked Amy if she's going to pay for it.
Who's the wife? Well, she's the wife or the husband?
Well, you're the father of the
I hope it pours and your hair gets frizzy. The both is.
How does it work? Two wives, husband, wife? What is this?
Is that Eddie? Ed, step out.
You see him?
He's
sitting
there. Do it like on a beach or something like that.
No, we're talking about you don't like beaches.
I don't want I don't want all that sand here in my house.
Yeah, we don't have. Yeah, God forbid we have sand in the house.
Huh?
Your daughter's a lesbian marrying a woman.
No way.
Your son over there, Don Juan, is spreading the seed all over Brooklyn. You're worried about sand in the house.
Don't want it.
She rose.
No,
I'm trying to be patient with you.
No, Susan's coming. Suck it up.
You gotta let all this stuff go.
Don't
worry about
the
sand.
You can't get sand up with a regular vacuum.
But Susan's
coming.
Don't worry about the sand.
He's still afraid.
And if you say another word, I swear to God, okay? Is that enough for you? You understand me? Look at me. Hey, I don't care if you're a big shot police officer. In this house, you're my son, and you'll do what I tell you. You go outside, you can do anything you want. As long as you're sitting at this table, you shut your mouth, and you listen to me. You understand?
Pass me the bread.
I'm going to kill this fucking
kid. Listen to your father, goddammit!
I'm going to kill him, and I'm going to go to jail. That's what's going to happen.
That's all right. It's going to be worth it.
And you tell the mailman.
Hey, don't be a smartass, okay?
You want to be part of my life. You have to.
Don't complain about your mother's cooking. I'll tell you right now.
All right, tough guy.
All right, tough guy. I'm a tough guy now. Rose, come on. Our first granddaughter.
One more time.
There was an ultrasound.
Granddaughter. What is
grandchild. It was an ultrasound. It's a girl.
Look who's that by. Oh,
Jimmy.
Hi,
hello,
all.
Jim.
Hi, Jimbo.
Hey, Jimbo.
How are you, Jim?
Me? Okay.
Salud. We love you, Jim.
Salud. We love you, Jim.
Well, apparently somebody doesn't. Did you see my garden?
We saw your garden, Jim.
I had a chance to win this competition. I think I'm out now.
Well,
you're out, all right.
Dinner. Sorry.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
New bread.
Woohoo! Here's a big one.
Oh, you should come over Tuesday. We haven't had those.
Stop like that. You're trying to talk her into leaving. No, come here, pussycat. I know.
Just watch the light,
Jay.
Give somebody I'll give somebody $100 to say cut.
Che suscita l'amore, poiché quel occhio al cuore onnipotente avvale.